All right, everybody, Baron here, and welcome back to Tabs. Look in the bottom right corner. Build 0.8. Weren't we just at 0.7? Is Halloween tomorrow? Check the roadmap. Everything seems to be normal.
Whoa.
There is a spooky campaign. We've got Halloween. The first one is Bone, and when you look at this, they're all singular words. The campaigns are often not like that. They're sentences or fragments of sentences. I'm no English major. I just speak the language. But Bone, Fire, Candle, Blood, Pumpkins. Oh my goodness. Invasion. Ooh, invasion. So let's check out Bone. Now, I believe that there's two spooky maps added. I've got to say, oh my god. That is the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. Oh, I want giant spiders so badly. So we're going to see just how many units are added in this spooky faction. Oh, it wouldn't be Tabs without at least one derpy character. They did mention candles. I don't know if these things are going to come to life, but the jack-o'-lanterns are impressive. We've got some relatively simple skeleton. I say simple in terms of their abilities, but they look impressive. Now, to fight them, I got to use anything I want. I've got $1,800. The pirate faction just came out, so you know what? The best thing I think to break skeletons is blunderbusses. And bombs. I mean, who doesn't like a good bomb? And then obviously the fodder units. So let's go ahead and check out. This is like the medieval one map. Now there's no water. You can finally see the snake skeleton. I wish he could come to life. I wonder. They didn't mention any new secret units. The door is still closed. Speak, friend, and enter. Where's Gandalf? But let's go ahead and see how the new pirate faction is going to do against the even newer Halloween spooky faction. Now remember, those were just the muskets from the initial peasants, so their musket balls are weaker. I don't know, maybe they ran out of cotton balls. Here come the blunderbusses and bombs, and we've got skeletons going everywhere. Do you remember the modded unit that we showed off? Hold on, let me shut up for a second, because listen to this. Oh my god, the sound effects are gorgeous. Whoa! What happened to this guy? Is he frightened? I think he's frightened and he's running. Do they have magic? Is there a magic-wielding unit down here? Listen to the bones. Come on, dude, throw a bomb. Oh, I thought that was a bomb. It's just a skeleton head rolling around. Okay, not the best throw. The back skeleton hit it. Oh my god, watch that again. So the back skeleton hit it, and it ran into his friend, or it was knocked into his friends, and they all died. Okay, so the bombardier just needs, yes. Okay, he threw two bombs. Hopefully it bounces off the shield. Nope, or the tree rather. That's what I was hoping, but skeletons aren't smart. I mean, Tab's units in general aren't very smart. Please don't get stabbed. Oh, he got frightened. I think when they get stabbed, they get frightened, and he's clearly paralyzed. So that's a very cool effect. There we go. Oh my god, I got defeated. I'm also very curious to see how arrows do against skeletons. They do have shields, so I'm now... Well, never mind. That was a really good first salvo, I think. Gentlemen, I need more salvos than that. There are a lot of enemies coming. They keep getting distracted by this guy who's frightened and running from the battle. That might be one of the coolest things that we've seen in the spooky patch. And I realize that we're just now into this for the first time, looking at our first bits of units. The scaring of the enemy. So, okay, yeah, clearly, even though you may be dead, friendly fire, they still are deciding to hold their swords between their legs as if that is a viable tactic and not the funniest taunt I've ever seen. Caw! Oh my god, there's an owl. Please be a secret unit. Oh. So spider, there's a lot more flora and fauna around. So this one is called fire. Okay, and I see why. They've got fire arrows. Guys, oh my god. This spooky faction is already one of my favorites. Okay, what do we need to do against this? We know what we need to do. The Viking faction, a few berserkers to jump and mix it up with those guys. So some berserkers, and these guys I think should easily handle. Let's see if the berserkers did not do what I wanted them to do, which was jump over. Okay, everybody's frightened and... What happened to this guy? I think the berserker was frightened and jumping at the same time. And this fire damage is burning our units up. That was the quickest defeat. All right, we need to distract them. The Valkyries aren't going for the units I wanted them to, but the Berserkers finally did as instructed, which was dispatch the fire archers. I've got to say, though. Oh, look at this. See? This is what I'm talking about. You're frightened? Well, you could get frightened and fall off a cliff. And this almost looked like a skeleton from a distance, did it not? Almost like the Punishers. Now, are these guys alive? Oh, with these guys being alive down here? That will definitely complicate things. I think there should be spikes or they die from the fall damage. You plummet that fall, you gotta die. Okay, candles. Okay. Some sort of sorcery with the candlemen? I don't know what this is all about, but I'm excited to find out. My soldiers are not. Well, I didn't spend all my money, but I want to see what they do. So we're going to send these guys. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, I thought there was a new unit, but like, oh my God, the candles are actually rocket propelled technology. Someone get Elon Musk on the phone. He needs to learn about this new source of propulsion. This is how we're getting to Mars, boys. Candle technology. And of course, there's the chicken. I see you guys can attack from range with your amazing candle technology. Oh, is that not beautiful? How about some Renaissance black powder technology? I guess they're using magic and we're using tech. We've taken some of the candles out. You see those bones in the background? All right, guys, please reload faster. I don't want to, yeah, this is good. Fire! Fire! Oh, look at that. I still think, oh my God. Just look at this. The levels are getting even better, which is amazing to think. Uh-oh. Blood? Oh my God, they're vampires. Excuse me, sir. That's not how you Nosferatu. Did you ever watch those old movies about vampires? And whenever they found out that some vampire was living in a castle on the hill, what they did was they sent an army of children? Or am I doing revisionist history here? Oh, snap! They turned to bats! What is going on? Look at that, they even got little faces! Oh my God, they have their haircuts still. That is a nice touch. That is a Tabs thing right there. So, needless to say, against vampires, I opted for... Whoa, 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 whoa. Hold on. Hold the phone. Wait, is that... That's the blood-sucking animation? Look. Do they convert? I guess they're not really zombies, right? Oh, God. I feel really guilty about just sending all of these children soldiers to their doom against vampires. Because this is a feeding frenzy. They're gorging on the blood. Well, that was a bad idea. All right. Two pirate captains. They're the new unit from the last patch. Let's see how well they do. Oh, my God. They're going to get ganked. Yeah, this was a bad idea. Oh, wait a minute. Okay. So they jump. I know what we need. What you need is the bait and the boom. The bait is going to attract all the vampires because I think they're going to leap at the earliest targets they see. And then the bombs were supposed to be doing a little bit better, and now the bombardiers are getting wrecked. So maybe I should have done a conga line. The bomber's still trying. You know what? I think a ninja could throw enough shuriken. We've got a little bit of distraction here. The grenade should do okay. The ninja should be able to keep throwing. Oh my God. I don't know how much health a vampire has. The shuriken may not be doing enough. They are not doing enough. But the bombs are supposed to be doing better. Supposed to. But they're not. Wait. Oh God. Please do something. I guess the only thing you can really do. Look at that. He bites his, what, neck? I love how they go for the neck. And little head, man. See? This is how you beat vampires. If they bite the neck, you just need to have a small neck. Throw the bomb! Yes! Oh, Mr. Small Neck. That could not have worked out better for us. This one's called Pumpkin, and they have pumpkin bone catapults. Oh my God. They're manned by skeletons, and we've got some, I almost said clowns. I don't know why. They're not clowns, guys. They are candle tech. Well, I decided to go for the samurai here. We've got a Hawacha. I want to see what the Hawacha does. I'm actually very curious. Oh my God, they just keep bouncing? Okay, that was a terrible strategy now that we know, but we do know now. The samurai are kind of blocking the candles. I guess there is still a chance if you were to throw out the fact that they have 8 catapults in the background that have largely been untouched. So if you're thinking what I'm thinking, maybe the Vikings will be best for this with the Berserkers and the Valkyries. Well, we had to spend a lot on the Valkyries, so they better do their job. Oh my God, they've already taken out two of the catapults over here. Let's go ahead and check on the other side to see how we're doing. The candles should be pretty decent at anti-air, I think. But the Vikings, it's just like, that's what I love about Tabs. It's rock, paper, scissors, if you know the right units. And the Berserkers are generally the counter to anything that does range. Oh, this is the second spooky level. This is gorgeous. Okay, so the second level, it's definitely from the Dynasty faction. We got the catapults, and this was, over here was the first, oh my God. But my God, this is beautiful. Who are we fighting? What's the new one? We got some vampires and a conga line. Wait. Oh, this one already turned to a bat. I thought he was carrying, we've got the firework archers and skeletons, the catapults. I'm looking to see if they have a new unit. But I'm not seeing anything. It's just the combined arms of all of the units that we've seen so far. Well then, we need a combined army of Vikings and Samurai. All right, so the Berserkers are already doing their thing, distracting the pumpkins. Somehow we got a pumpkin firing over this way, which I think is great. Some firework archers to increase the absolute anarchy. And my warriors didn't go on the bridge. These ones did, so they're fighting, and the firework archers are doing their thing. However, that unit being able to cause fear and fright and force our units into a retreat is just brilliant. I still think we should be able to hold this one out because they can't withstand very good. Wait, is this guy new? No, he's a fire. Okay, he's a regular fire archer, but he's just sitting over here brilliantly hanging out. What can we do against that? Oh, and look at this. There's no connection between these upper three areas because of the, I guess it looks like a bunch of just like evil roots. Oh, please walk off. Oh, okay. So the fire arrows get extinguished on shields. Oh my God, please don't fall. Okay, we lost a guy, but I still have three units. This guy's gonna have to kill all three of them. All three of them specialize in taking arrows. Oh, he almost hit it back. Oh, that was beautiful. Okay, Mr. Skelly. You've been weighed, you've been measured, and you, sir, have been found wanting, and you will die under the full moon. Well, I guess you're already dead, right? You're a skeleton. Get him, Samurai! No freaking way! Guys, he's over there. What is the major malfunction? And the skeleton explodes in a shower of bones. Okay. This is a new unit. His hands are locked in a, it looks like a Chinese finger trap. But he's got telekinesis? Is it Magneto? This is Magneto, isn't it? And you thought Marvel was done. Well, obviously not, but Tabs mods anyway. Okay, let's see what he does. He's got a thing of shields around, or swords, so maybe we'll counter that with some shields. I put one of the new pirate faction harpooners in here, and then a standard army of Vikings. Whoa! Okay, I didn't realize we also had vampires. What the heck? There's a sword here. Where do these guys come from? Oh, that's the harpooner. The vampires are flanking us. Did he throw it? Is this guy throwing swords? Oh my God, he is. Oh, look at that. The shields are working. So he's a range specialist. Oh my gosh, range specialist. Yeah, then I'm glad we brought a bunch of shields to battle. We still have a lot of melee guys. And unfortunately, they're causing us to run in fear. The only... That is the brilliance of that mechanic. Okay. They cause fear, so we need to pick them apart before they get to us. I just realized if we encounter this guy again, I've got archers on the left, archers on the right, archers in the middle with some musketeers, and a painter who's clearly taking this archer for a ride. He wants him as some body armor. But... did we take out any of the vampires on their way here? Oh yeah, I forgot they turn into bats, which makes them very difficult to kill. But what I wanted to test was this. Do the painters, which dodge incoming ranged fire, dodge incoming vampires? No, they just kind of ran around them. Okay, so painters may not be the best. However, they're pretty good bang for their buck. Some of the vampires fell in the water and they're just clubbing the rest of them. So what we have to worry about, oh God. Ranged units are supposed to be dealing with these guys who have shields. Okay, we've got some arrows. We've got them pincered. I guess it's almost more like a trincer. It's not a word. Mexican standoff? I don't know. We pulled them in three different directions as opposed to two. We split their forces. And aside from being scared and trying to paint the archers blue... Oh my god, that was brilliant. Look at that. Okay, this one is ritual. And there's just a lot of ranged fire from all sides. A few skellies as well. Oh my god, how much money do I get? Oh, well then you know what I'm doing. Two pirate queens. And then I'm thinking dynasty samurai. All right, I don't know if the pirate queens are gonna be the best for this, but they're awesome and they're new. Oh my god! There's definitely some friendly fire happening. Oh man, with all the fire arrows and all the range stuff, I don't think the pirate queen's gonna be the best. She does escape into the air. Oh, look at this. Okay. Yeah, this is what you call a bad strategy. Hi, I've got a unit that is getting pincushioned by swords and fire arrows. Oh my god, the pirate queen. How strong are you? Throw your bombs, please. Please throw your bombs. This is unreal. I have no idea how strong she is. Is she the last unit? No, we've got the other pirate queen still up, but probably about to die. Yeah, she's definitely about to die. My goodness. Yes, the berserkers are out. Hopefully we can take this guy down. If we can take one of them even down. Come on, come on, guys. What? How strong is he? He's got so many swords. What's the best counter? I guess ranged fire would probably be the best counter. When he's supported, I have serious reservations for our chances of winning. But if we can take down this second one here, then okay. Berserkers, once again, my favorite unit to counter range specialists, we'll call them. Because right now, in samurais, they're always pretty good, you know, men of the line, filler units. This one is called The End. Oh my goodness. We have a new dark peasant in town, guys. I don't know. Oh god, and they've got armies on the left and the right? In order to see what this... he almost looks like a... Yeah, he's definitely the Grim Reaper. Is all about... I just spammed foot soldiers. I just want a giant army because... I think he's gonna do something with those, like, giant wing tentacles or whatever they are. Oh my god, he's picking them up! What? He's holding them. Now what does he do? He kills them? He's spinning them around in a circle? No. What are they doing? Okay, he's able to kill, like, six units. My god, that army died so fast. Okay, that didn't work. I went all Renaissance, guys. Well, in pirate. We've got one giant cannon in the back. Okay, if he's not firing from where he is, I shouldn't have put him there. The cannon didn't work. I think we just spent a lot of money on a cannon that may not be doing anything. And the musketeers... Wait, did we take out the Reaper at least? No, we have not. Hold on. If you want it done, you gotta do it yourself. Retreat! Okay, I got taken out of the air. Oh, the cannon just destroyed him. Okay. The cannon wasn't a good spot, and too many muskets. I wonder if the painters can dodge the Grim Reapers. Oh, that was very good musket shots. All right, what's going on over here? We've got some fencers dealing with vampires. It's okay. I guess it's going okay. Now, this is what I'm curious about. Now I expect us to be firing, sir, our range. All right, well, that was my shot. Didn't work out too well. The vampires are coming in out of nowhere. Retreat! Oh! I went for the pirate queen. I mean, she's the new big bad Mama Jamma over here, so... Oh, the arrows are really good. Oh, those bombs are definitely gonna do some friendly fire on my painters. Okay, let's see this. What happens when... Oh my god! Okay, if it's a boss unit, the Grim Reaper will not, I repeat, will not attack him with the tentacles, but knocking them in the water right there basically just took out $2,500 of my army right here. Oh my god, just making quick work of everybody else. They still got the sword throwers. Yeah. Maybe more archers at the beginning to take out that first salvo. No bomb throwers either. Okay, I don't know why. These poor horses. There's vampires out there and things that shoot sword with magic. But I sent the jouster. Oh my god, that was a terrible idea. The poor jouster and his horse. Okay, but there we go. The Grim Reaper is down. It did its purpose, that poor horse. You fought bravely. We need a name for that horse. What name should we name our warhorse who sacrificed itself for a glorious charge against the Grim Reaper? Oh, you don't like arrows in your nuts, do you? I don't think anybody really does. But you can't even grab it out with your hands because your hands are locked in. Stop shooting swords at me. Oh, God. His swords, man. Somebody with arrows, shoot that man. Shoot that man. Oh, God, it's bad. Oh, he's dead. Painter! Painter! Oh my God, we were so close to victory this time. Oh, brilliant. We took out this sword guy with the first salvo of arrows. This one was taken out as well. The Reaper is still alive, but he's starting to get pincushion. I think he's more of a glass cannon type unit, where he does incredible damage, but I think he's weak. We took him down relatively fast last time. Can we please do that again? He's the last unit alive right now. There's a few vampires over on the leftward flank. Gentlemen, you are all about to die unless you do something about it. Oh my God, thank goodness. Thank goodness you chose to do something about it. What's going on over here? We got a skelly who's deciding to go swimming. Sir, your bones are not going to be very durable in water. You'll break down over time. Okay, there's the fright mechanic. Here's a couple of arrows being flown from the other side of the map. We only have three archers left on the other side of the map. And then this guy. And clearly, no one is accurate enough. There we go. He's not moving. He blocked one. Okay. His shield is small. Come on. Where's the follow-up arrows? Oh my God. Did he block that one again? Yeah. Wait. Oh, there's a bat. What are you doing over here? Oh, he went into bat mode. Yeah! I have achieved victory. All right, so now we have to use the spooky units. Okay, so let's see what they all are. The Reaper is 2,500. Swordcaster is 1,000. Pumpkin Catapult's 1,000. Vampire's 200. Candlehead's 200. Skeleton Archers and Skeleton Warriors 100 and 140. Well, it seems weird seeing the Halloween units in a light map right now, but I guess in order to take over the world, they're going to have to go out and explore new realms. It's going to be interesting. I want to see how good the Halloween faction is. Oh my God, we're getting riggedy-riggedy wreck right now. Maybe unit composition wasn't the best. There are bone mages. I mean, if you think about, if there's any unit in the game that should be able to deal with skeletons, it's a bone mage. I mean, he knows all about the bones. He can control the bones. Lord of Bones. You guys better shoot him or you're gonna die. So they're like the Frost Archers in that they're not really immediate kills. They're more like do damage over time. And there's your sternum. Lord of Bones for a skeleton army. Oh, I'm out of money. That's probably not gonna work. The bone mages alone killed everybody. All archers in a circle. Defensive circle formation. All right, too many bone mages are still alive. Actually, they're mostly all dead. There's one or two left. This is actually gonna work. Okay, I think this is the last guy. Look at that. Sir, do you like fire? I know you cavemen, that was the first big technological breakthrough in the history of mankind was fire. And I think like maybe the tool shortly after that, but it was your demise, sir. All right, so build 0.8.0, AKA the spooky Halloween. We got scary, spooky skeletons. We've got campaigns. And we've got two new maps, Spooky 1 and Spooky 2. Spooky 2 is just gorgeous, man. In the moon, oh, it's incredible. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, the standard 7 units. Now, whether or not they're secret units, they didn't advertise any secret units. So I'm not aware if there are or are not. But here you have it from lowest and simplest to the greatest of all time. The Grim Reaper, if he was just like in that robe, he wouldn't look so scary. But when you see him flying with this, this is something out of like, I don't know, a Marvel Comics movie, man. You know, I just realized, why didn't we test the Reaper on this? I don't know if the Bone Mage is gonna do too well. They're all split in a circle and he's not really getting boned. Sounds funny, doesn't it? Because he's flying above them. Yeah, you may be able to control bones, but none of you... Okay, that was the first spear that actually stuck. Oh my God, so they may have the bodies, but he'll drop them and go get more. Okay, he's been hit by three spears. Dude, this guy's amazing.
The Grim Reaper. Yeah.
Aww. He's been defeated, and look, he was a skeleton this whole time. Alright guys, thank you for watching another episode of Totally Agga Battle Simulator. Let me know what you'd like to see in the next one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you there.